Sadiq, obviously the run in the UFC has been perfect so far. Co-main event, network television. I mean, does this feel like a big moment for you?
Yeah. It feels like the natural progression, you know. I'm happy to be back, man. That's one of the best things, man. I've been gone for way too long. I'm happy to be back and be back in a big way.
What was the focus during the time away? I mean, you had kind of all this momentum, right? And then it got put on hold. So what was the focus?
Yeah, it wasn't really a focus. It was just kind of like one bad news after the other, you know. So, like, first the COVID stuff hit, quarantine, gym got locked down. Then I lost another family member. And then after that, the stuff with my passports for the Edson fight. So it was just like one bad news after the next. Just a streak of bad luck, that's all. But, hey, we're past it now, and we're ready to work.
I was going to ask, so obviously things are good right now, but during that time, and do you ever start, like, getting down a little bit or thinking, like, what's going on?
I was down all the way till last week, you know. I got to make sure I'm not going to feel good until the bell, the cage is the cage closed, you know, because it's been rough, you know. This is the way I make a living. I've gone over a year with zero income, you know. That, like, it's been really rough. I'm just happy I have good people around me, family members and friends that was able to pick me up every time I fell down.
So as far as, you know, this opportunity, do you change anything? I mean, have you just been kind of keeping the same groove all the way, building up to it, or did you have to tweak anything?
There's a running joke in my gym. I've been in training camp for about a year now, you know. So it's not really about tweaking or changing anything. It was just waiting for an opportunity.
When you get in there, will there be nerves in this spot? I mean, is it different? Is it a different feel, or is this just another day in the office for you?
No, it is what it is, you know. Like, it's fun. At the end of the day, we're punching each other in the face. The nerves are kind of maxed out when you make your amateur debut. So for me, it never really changes. You know, I'm prepared. I put the energy in the right place, and I go out there and I do what I do.
Talk about the matchup itself. Obviously, Arnold got quite the run as well, right? I mean, he's got an impressive career record. So when they threw that name at you, were you excited about it? What did you think?
Yeah. When I got that name, I kind of figured me and Arnold was going to fight each other deeper into our careers. I wasn't expecting us to fight each other this early. But then when I saw that I was having a hard time getting somebody to fight me and he was having a hard time getting someone to fight him, I was like, sooner or later, their hands are going to be forced to kind of just match us up against each other, you know. So it is a good challenge, man, and I'm excited. It's a good name. A win over Arnold will put me, like, straight. I think after this, man, I might try to call out top six, top seven.
I was going to ask you, I mean, a win here, you know, you've obviously kind of had that prospect tag for a long time, right? People saw you coming up, but a win here, you feel like now we're talking about contender type stuff?
Yeah. I think it's time for us to leave the prospect title behind us, you know. Like, after this one, it's definitely possibly fighting for the title, you know. Like, I see a clear path towards that after this fight.
As far as the matchup itself, is there anything he does in particular that you're most concerned about or anything that impresses you the most?
He's well-rounded all around, you know. I don't think there's anything that stands out big, like I have to watch out for this. It's just being solid all around. I feel like we're kind of similar fighters in a lot of ways. It's just opposite stances.
Yeah. Last thing for me, give me the goal here. I mean, obviously you talk about the time away. I'm sure just, you know, getting a win and collecting two paychecks would be nice, you know. But is it just that, or does it feel like, you know, going in there and making a statement, you know, doing something spectacular?
I definitely want my two paychecks. Trust me. Don't nobody want to go home with one paycheck. But, yeah, like I said, I feel like I've been gone for a while. A couple of people might have forgot who I was, you know. So I definitely got to – that's not going to be difficult, you know, because anybody that's seen me fight, they just got to watch me fight again to remember, you know. My fighting style is pretty exciting. So it's not necessarily doing anything that's out of my character. It's just getting the opportunity to perform, and that's what I'm happy about, to be back here with the opportunity to perform.
Hey, Matt, you mentioned there's a joke that you've been in training camp for a year. We sometimes hear fighters say that training day-to-day is one thing, but when you have a fight at the end of it, that can really get you motivated. So when you're going for a year without that, how tough is it to just get up and go to the gym and just go through it all over and over?
Yeah, so the thing is, the joke about the training camp for a year is, like, my training schedule never really changes much with me having a fight. The only thing that changes is that now I have an opponent to focus on, and I might address, like, certain skills and stuff like that. But the training has always been pretty consistent. And I did have a matchup with Edson last year, so I was preparing for that. And before that, I was still training pretty consistently. So the joke about me being in training camp for a year is just that, like, I've just been pushing the same kind of intensity for about a year straight, you know, and without somebody in front of me.
Is there any fear that you could hurt yourself by doing that, or is that just what's worked for you?
No, it's exactly that's how it is. It's what's worked for me so far. I'll feel more fear or strain away from that than I would keeping it up.
And last thing for me, any difference in fighting a bit earlier on in the day?
No, I've always been kind of all around my whole career. You know, I fought overseas, I fought in different countries. Even when I first got into the UFC, I fought in Australia, and that was like a Sunday morning, you know. So that I think it's all good. At the end of the day, I'm going to be fighting around, I think, afternoon time. That's going to be even better, honestly, because now after the fight is over, you get to go enjoy the rest of the day. You know, it's not just locking in. I'm not the most partying kind of guy. So most of the time after my fights, is the only thing that's open is like clubs and stuff like that. At least now I can get to enjoy the regular boring people's life.
Welcome back, my man. Your opponent also is coming off of a layoff, and you guys match up well with people kind of not necessarily jumping at the chance to see you in that cage. What does it say that we got two boogeymen fighting one another?
Yeah, it means both of us are ready to step up, you know. That's why we both accepted it, you know, because nobody was trying to really give us a good shot in the higher rankings. I was like, hey, it is what it is. We're going to have to fight each other and then wish each other luck in the future, you know.
That's perfect. So do we, layoffs or not, do we anticipate like a hard 15 minutes from you guys? Or if you can get the finish, you get it.
Hey, if I could go in there and walk out in 1 second, I would happily do that. Trust me, don't listen to these fighters when they tell you that they want to go in there and have a 15-minute war. Nobody wants to have a 15 or 25-minute war. I like to go in there, throw one punch at Arnold, and walk right back out the ring. But I do prepare for all three rounds.
Perfect. Thank you, sir. Welcome back, and best of luck on Saturday.
Thank you.